And now, your Big 2 Local Weather Authority forecast. We warn you first with Chief Meteorologist Chase Menendez.
Chase Menendez joining us 6 feet apart. This is the new normal.
This is what we got going on here. I know. Handshakes, no more. It's been intense.
Yeah.
I'm a hugger. Anybody who's ever met me, I'm a hugging kind of guy. So it's a little bit difficult, but you know, at least the weather's been cooperating for so far.
That's true. The weather's beautiful, but you can't go outside. I mean, come on.
Well, you can go outside. You just gotta watch out.
That's true.
Definitely a good weekend to hit the parks. And actually, I hear rumors that we may be opening some parks pretty soon too. This weekend, maybe another chance for that. But before we get there, we've actually got some pretty good conditions going on tonight as well. Not a whole lot of activity here on the sky tracker. We are seeing a little bit of cloud cover out there, some haze overhead. But for the most part, really calm conditions, especially compared to where we were earlier today with those very breezy winds out there. Things not bouncing around too much here on the sky tracker in Midland at all. So quiet conditions, and thanks to that sky tracker network, we've got a good look outside right now. But there is a lot of activity here in the United States right now. We're just kind of in a calm spot here in West Texas. You can see a lot of energy brewing across parts of Colorado, making its way into the panhandle of Texas. We also saw some very strong winds earlier today, and actually, as you head into the afternoon, noontime, you can see those clouds accelerating across parts of the panhandle of Texas. And now we're also seeing a lot of thunderstorm activity down to the southeastern states. But again, West Texas kind of in a good spot. We're seeing some very calm conditions overhead, just a little bit of cloud cover, a nice change of pace compared to what's going on in other parts of the country. South of I-10, really not a lot of activity either. Still seeing some clouds whipping on through, moving through very quickly, thanks to some extremely strong upper level winds that have been going on overhead all day today and translating to the surface, giving us those strong winds here in West Texas earlier in the day. Thankfully, everything again has calmed down, but with that westerly wind coming in, pushing those clouds off from west to east, we've picked up pretty significantly. High temperatures picked up to 84 degrees for this afternoon, and 80 degrees is the average for this time of year. Lows picking up to 57, so again, on the high side of average, just like our highs were, but thankfully, we're steering clear of records so far. We've actually got a pretty nice warming trend that's going to be taking place for the next couple of days, kicking our high temperatures up even more than what we had today. And also wind speeds are going to be making a return tomorrow as well. By the time we get to about 8 a.m., you can see those winds picking up to 11 miles per hour for Odessa Midland, but 20 in places like Pecos, with some exceptionally breezy conditions across the Trans-Pecos. But the more important thing is actually those wind arrows and the direction that they're pointing in, coming from west to east, is going to do a good job of pulling in more warm air for tomorrow afternoon. Very similar setup to what we had today, but a little bit calmer. Notice our wind speeds picking up to 6 miles per hour by about 6 p.m. for Odessa Midland, and a little bit higher in the Guadalupe Pass, but nowhere near the 20s and 30s that we saw earlier today. And those winds won't be lasting for too long. They'll actually be dying down in the overnight hours as we head on into our Tuesday. But tomorrow morning is going to be pretty warm. 50s is what we can expect to begin the day. Wind speeds about 10 to 15 miles per hour in the AM hours, picking up a little bit as we head to the afternoon and then dying down for the evening time. But it is going to be a pretty pleasant ride, if not a dry one. The wind coming in from the west pushed a lot of this moisture here all out of the way and all the way off to the east, allowing our humidity numbers to drop down substantially. Now, these numbers generally change depending on the time of day, but when we see them drop down into the teens, that really indicates some dry conditions. Pecos at 12%, 18% for Guadalupe Pass. Thankfully, Odessa Midland recovering a little bit, up to 20% now. As we head to the morning time, those numbers usually increase a little bit, but back off to their lowest point in the afternoon time. And notice single digits in a lot of locations. Now, couple that with some warm conditions, some breezy conditions, like we'll see for most of the rest of this week, we are going to be dealing with the possibility for some fire weather concerns. So that'll definitely be something to look out for. As well, a lot of sunshine helping to warm our temperatures up. 85 degrees will be our temperature by 4 p.m., but our high temperature actually coming a little bit after that mark and a little bit warmer as well. We're going to see our highs picking up to 87 for Odessa Midland tomorrow afternoon and up to 90 degrees by Tuesday afternoon as we see rain chances pick up on Tuesday evening as well because of those high temperatures that are going to be picking up. Now, we'll drop off on Wednesday to 85, Thursday at 88, and Friday down to 84, but notice next week getting near the triple digits, Gian.